Come on. Wake up, Victor. I haven't even told you what I've planned for Cassandra.
Check the cardiographic monitors.
Rosa killing your sister and her son's wife. That could be something which could turn the tables for you, Meningning. That could be your new ticket to freedom.
But that would only happen if Eleanor testifies. But my lawyer is even telling me that her testimony might not even stand in court. Because if she was indeed telling the truth, then she should have said something about this before. My lawyer says the prosecution will think that Eleanor is just making things up.
Yes, but even so, I think we can still use this information. I mean, if Rosa and Mayor Violetta are friends, and you think Rosa killed your sister, maybe the mayor really is involved.
You're right, Alexei. We can really use this, Meningning. And you know what? Once we have proven that they are really the ones responsible for your twin sister's death, I assure you now that we are going to take them down and make them pay for putting you in jail and for killing your sister.
Wow, Rosa, I really can't believe that you would lie this much. You told me that you weren't planning anything against Meningning.
And what makes you think that I am lying to you this time, Harry?
It's not just me. The whole world knows.
So you actually paid one of Sigmund's maids to testify against Meningning?
I was there when she admitted everything.
Huh. Quite a show.
I'm afraid you're mistaken. You didn't listen to the whole story, Harry.
Didn't you hear the prosecution said
that it's highly likely that the congresswoman paid that maid to implicate my friend? You really have too much time in your hands. That's why your imagination is running wild. Good day, Harry.
You killed her, didn't you? You killed my wife!
Excuse me. Where's the patient here?
I'm sorry, we did everything we could to save him, but he went into cardiac arrest. Attorney Abad has been brought to the morgue.
What do you mean?
He's gone, miss.
No! No, this can't be happening! Victor!
Elena. Elena, calm down. Calm down, stop crying. We have to get out of here now, Elena.
This is all Rosa's fault, Andy. Victor died because of her!
Elena! Think of it this way. Maybe this is a blessing in disguise.
How can you say that? The man I love just died!
But if he had survived, then he could have gotten us in trouble.
I don't care. I don't care if they send me to jail. I just want Victor to be alive.
Don't be so stupid! Now come on! We have to get out of here! Hurry!
Do you still remember what you did the other night?
What do you mean, Mother?
Well, you just attempted to kill your husband.
Sigmund, is that true? Mother, why would I do that? I don't remember doing that. You know just how much I love my husband.
My mother's right, Eleanor. And do you remember that you almost hurt her the other day?
Well, that's why Sigmund and I decided that it is time for you to see a specialist.
I am not crazy, Mother, if that is what you're thinking. This is not the kind of thing that I want to start my day with. If you really must, why don't you go see a doctor? You are the one who has health problems, not me.
Oh dear.
Is this the story of Eleanor, my baby boy? Huh, you should not believe your mother-in-law. She's insane.
Just no more lies from you, Mother. I don't think I can still handle hearing any more lies from you.
You know, I can never hurt your brother Eric, right? He told you himself. What more you? Why would I even think of killing Daphne when I know that it will hurt you? I cannot do that to you. I can't do anything to hurt you, Charles.
You better pray that there is no evidence to prove that you killed my wife. Because if that happens, I don't care. I will be the first person to make sure that you will rot in jail.
How are you doing, Meningning? We haven't had the chance to talk the last time I saw you at your hearing.
I'm okay, Grandmother. Still alive and breathing.
That's what I really like about you. Even though you have so many problems, you still make me smile.
Grandmother, were you able to convince Eleanor to testify for me?
Oh, no. Do you remember how we used to joke that Eleanor might be crazy? Now, my dear, I think it's turning out to be true. Because just the other night, she attacked Sigmund. And she almost stabbed him. Because Eleanor thought that he was Rosa and that she was there to kill her. You know, Sigmund and I are terrified of her now. That's why we want to have her checked already. Because you never know. She might end up hurting someone else next time.
Thank you.
Sure.
Wow, that's a lot of stuff. Celebrating something with Armand?
Habagad, please don't start with me.
Oh, I'm sorry. Here, let me help you with that.
No, it's okay. I can handle it.
What? I can see that you can't. Come on, let me help you out.
Don't.
Then I can walk you home, okay?
Habagad.
Why is this such a big deal? This is just a friend helping out another friend, okay?
Is there a problem, Sandy?
No problem here, Armand. It's just that I saw Sandy needed some help, so I offered to help carry some of these bags. But since you're here, then there's no need for my help. Here. Well, I'll go ahead now. Have fun, you two. Sandy.
Bye.
Oh, Eric, visiting hours are almost over. What was so important that you had to come here?
Meningning, we just lost our one and only hope. Victor just died.
Miss Eleanor Pertera?
Yes, how can I help you?
You need to come with us now, madam.
And why would I do that?
Your family called us for help.
Mother, is this your idea? Or yours, Sigmund? I already made myself clear. I told you I am not crazy.
Eleanor, you need help.
Why can't you understand?
Madam, you have to come with us.
Will you let me go? I'm not coming with you!
Let me go! How did Victor die?
I don't know. They said that his body just gave up.
I'm starting to lose hope. He was the only person that can help me out. I think I've had enough. If one more problem comes my way, I don't think I can handle it.
We are going to find another way. I'm sure there's someone out there who can help. You can't lose hope now, Mening Ning. You have to hang on.
Sigmund, look, I'm perfectly fine. Will you look at me? I'm okay. I'm not crazy.
I'm sorry, Eleanor, but we're doing this for your own good.
No, I'm not crazy, Sigmund. Let me go. Let me go.
Where's my father?
They went out, madam.
Where did they go?
They took Madame Eleanor to the doctor. She went ballistic when they came to take her there. I think she's really gone crazy.
No, 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 don't close that door, no! Doctor, doctor, I'm not crazy! Doctor, please, you have
to
believe me!
Doctor, please tell me, how is my daughter-in-law doing?
No, don't close that door!
Based on our initial tests, she's suffering from extreme paranoia.
Now Victor is gone. You killed him, Rosa. My boyfriend is gone. My boyfriend is gone, Rosa. And he wouldn't have died if you hadn't shot him. All of this happened because of you.
I'm not the only one at fault here. Remember that, if you please. If you hadn't had Eric abducted, Victor wouldn't have turned on us. This is the fault of the both of us, Cassandra. It's not just me. Think of this. This death of Victor. There's one person who's the cause of all this, right? So you should blame her. Not you. Not me. It's Mening Ning. This is all her fault. It's all because of her, Cassandra. It's Mening Ning's fault that Victor is dead.
What could be the cause of her condition?
It can be caused by stress. Is she taking any medication?
Oh, doctor. I have lost count of all the medicines that Eleanor has been taking. Youth pills, beauty pills, slimming pills.
Any of those pills you mentioned can be the cause. One of those could have triggered her paranoia. And we also found a heavy concentration of hallucinogens in her body.
Mother!
I see.
Let's go, Mother.
And just in case she tells you any stories of killing and murder, I don't worry about that. Those are all part of her hallucinations.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Mother! Sigmund! I am not crazy! Sigmund, please let me out of here! Mother, please! Don't leave me here!
Great time, honey.
Shouldn't I be the one thanking you for what happened earlier?
Victor, I'm doing this so we won't be ruined.
No! We've both been ruined from the start. This is wrong. This has to end now.
To bring him to the hospital!
Mening Ning, I'm going to make you suffer for what happened to Victor. Just you wait.
You have to be strong, Moneyning. You should not lose hope. Even though Victor died, we can still try to convince Eleanor. She can still testify for you.
I doubt that, Mother. The last time I spoke with Grandmother, she said Eleanor's going crazy. They're planning to take her to the hospital. And when that happens, no one can testify for me. Maybe I'm just destined to stay and rot here in jail forever.
Moneyning. I heard that your former lawyer just bit the bullet. You're running out of options now. Maybe now's the right time to accept my offer.
Our condolences, Attorney Abad.
You said you wanted to talk to the both of us about something, Attorney.
Because I've seen just how far you both went to protect my son. And because I trust you both, I wanted to let you know that I just uncovered something about Victor's death. I hired people to investigate what really happened. Something unusual happened to my son, according to the doctors. At first, his condition was stable. But then he suddenly went into cardiac arrest. As you know, many people believe that patients who are comatose can hear people who talk to them. It's possible that someone talked to him that caused him stress, which led to his eventual death. And I'm quite certain that this person and the person who shot my son are the same.
Harry, how many times do I have to turn down all your offers to help? When will you ever stop?
Look, I'm just concerned about the two of you. I mean, if Sigmund's family can't help you with anything, then why not let me do something to help you out? I've done it for you a lot of times.
And then what will you ask for? You'll help and then you'll ask us to give you something in return? Never mind. Go and offer your help to someone else.
How come you're not saying anything? Well, you mean to tell me you agree with your mother?
Thanks, but no thanks, Harry. I can still handle it. But the minute I run out of options, I will surely ask for your help.
Okay, then. If you need my help, I'm just right here waiting.
Before, I couldn't ask the doctors to take out the bullet from his chest because it was crucial to my son's survival. But now that my son is gone, I can finally use that bullet to find the person who killed my son.
Attorney, Charles and I did some research about it, and we found out that every gun actually has a signature. Each gun has a mark, a unique mark, that can be found in every bullet it fires. Correct?
Attorney, once we get a hold of the gun, we will finally know who was the one who killed Victor.
You two know all of the people that my son was with just before he died. That's why I'm asking you to help me out so we can bring this person to justice.
Of course, you can count on us to help, Attorney Abad.
Yes.
Thank you.
Hey. Hey, thanks, Charles.
Oh, no problem.
Wait a minute. What did you make of all those things that Attorney Abad just told us?
Well, if it's true that Victor was intentionally killed while in a coma, then only one person could have done it.
Yes, I know. That person knew that once Victor wakes up, he or she is going to get in trouble.
You think so?
One of them, or maybe all three of them. We need to investigate more, Charles. Okay?
Okay.
Drive carefully. Thanks again.
Thanks.
We still haven't finished our conversation about Meng Ning. Will you leave her alone? You have to listen to me.
Stop telling me what to do. How many times do I have to tell you that there is no truth to what that lowly maid was talking about in court? I did not pay her. Maybe Congresswoman did.
You're something else. How long are you going to keep this up? Stand by all of your lies.
Madam, someone is here for you.
Mrs. Spray.
What is this about?
It's a subpoena, Mrs. Spray. The court is ordering you to be there for the hearing of Meng Ning Burgos.
But I don't want to do anything there.
This means I don't need to do anything now. The court is taking care of everything.
I'm sorry, but you can't refuse to appear before the court, Mrs. Spray. Because if you don't want to go to jail, you will show up. Have a good day, Mrs. Spray.
I actually fell into a...
Where?
A manhole. That's why I feel like I'm so shabby today.
Oh, really? Shabby?
You know that word now? I'm not sitting next to you. Yes, I'm definitely not sitting next to you.
Oh, will you?
Excuse me. Huh? Is Mr. Eric Ferganta here?
What's that?
Yes, that's me.
I know.
I have a package for you.
What is he holding?
Just sign on the dotted line.
Looks like a package.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Eric, what's that?
I don't know. I wonder who sent it. Can I have that?
Who is it from?
Oh, maybe it's from Lilibeth. I'm sure she misses you already.
No, wait. You shouldn't open it. It might be...
Why not?
Didn't someone send Meng Ning the same thing? Oh, no. They sent her in jail, right? This might be a bomb.
Hey. No, it can't be. This isn't a bomb.
Well, what is it?
Oh, it's a cellular phone.
And it looks expensive.
Wait, maybe it has a bomb inside.
It's from Victor.
Just sent to Meng Ning, but in case that letter doesn't reach her, I'm sure that this will reach you, because they would never think of keeping an eye on you. I've always been a step ahead of them. That's why I'm one of the best lawyers.
Mother, I have to show this message to Meng Ning. This could be what can get her out of jail.
I heard what happened to Victor. My condolences, Cassandra.
I really don't need your sympathy. And I know that you're the reason why Victor is now dead.
Hold on, why are you blaming me for this? I don't even have any idea how it happened. Weren't you the one who took him to the hospital? Why don't you tell us who really shot him, huh?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
You know, Cassandra, no matter how hard you deny it, I know that you know everything. And you know what I really think? I think that before he was shot, you wanted to stop Victor. Because you knew that he was going to turn on you. Maybe you are the one who shot him.
How dare you!
Don't you dare!
How dare you!
Let me go!
I'll die because of you!
Meng Ning!
Take care of the stomach!
Hey, stop that! That's enough!
Hey, let go of her! Who are you anyway?
Use your nails!
Hey, stop that! That's enough!
Let go of me!
Stop it, please! Everybody
quiet! This is not yet over, Meng Ning!
You bet it's not over! I'm going to wait for you! We're going to have a great time here in jail!
Stop it! Stop that! Back to your cells!
Don't touch me!
Hey, stop that! Back to your cells!
And as for you, Mening Ning, next time that you're in a fight, just tell me.
Well, thanks. You didn't have to help me out. I can take her.
And who was that girl anyway?
Well, who else but my good-for-nothing sister Cassandra?
Now look, your hair's a mess.
I know. It took you a while to fix it. Now look at it.
It took me a while to curl it.
How is it? Can you fix it?
Oh,
I hate it.
I
look what
scared.
She did. Is it okay?
Next time, you tell me, all right?
It was my fight.
You did the right thing, Charles. Good thing you didn't let her see you. Once our mother finds out that you know about her gun, she might try to get rid of it.
But how will we ever be able to use it against Mother? We don't even have a search warrant to go through all of the things in our house and find the gun.
Well, we might not have to wait too long now because of what Victor just said. We might be able to get a search warrant from the police.
Hey, have you seen what's inside the phone that Victor sent?
No, I haven't seen it yet. I thought I'd keep it first. I have to be careful. People are keeping an eye on this house. Maybe I'll look at it tomorrow when I go visit Mening Ning.
Thing is, I'm worried about what's inside that package Victor sent. What if our mother is...
As long as we haven't seen it yet, you shouldn't jump to any conclusions. Don't think about it too much.
Why don't you calm down? Here's a glass of juice. I made this specially for you. I'm telling the truth. There is something weird going on in this house. No. I believe you. Now, calm down and relax. Take these pills to relax your body and to clear your mind. Do you think this will help? It works for me. Okay. Thank you, Cassandra. You're welcome. Where are the medicines, Cassandra? I need them. I keep on dreaming of Daphne's death, and I haven't had an hour of sleep. I'm sorry, Eleanor. I ran out of stock. I could have them deliver it, but then you'd have to wait. So, would you please get out of my room? But I need it now. Not tomorrow. Not later today. I really need the medicines now, or else I'll go crazy! Will you please stop, Eleanor? You're hurting me! Then give me the damn medicine. I know that you use it yourself, so you have your own stash. I am warning you, Cassandra. I will get that medicine, even if I have to kill you!
Cassandra attacked you here.
Oh, yes. Good thing I was there to save her. I didn't know her sister was like that.
Hey, thanks. And how are you, Mening Ning?
Oh, you shouldn't be asking me that. You should ask Cassandra how she is, because before the guards came to stop us, I really made sure that I beat her badly.
Oh, that's good. Hey, do you Remember the letter that Victor sent, the one you got?
Don't remind me about that anymore. Nothing came out of it.
Here. He actually sent me another package at home.
A cellular phone?
It's Victor's phone. There might be some things inside that can help us.
Wow. Could all those things be true, Manning Ning?
Only the court has the right to decide that, Alexei. Has anyone else seen all of this?
No, we're the first ones.
Then you have to go and get a hold of my lawyer right away. I just don't know how I can thank Victor for this. Even though he's gone, he still kept his promise of getting me out of jail.
It won't be long, we'll be together again.
I hope so, Eric.
Yuck! Will you stop? You're so corny!
You're just jealous.
Well, a little. Oh, where's your brother, by the way?
Oh, he's running some errands.
Have you talked to him about me yet?
Oh, stop it.
I'm still trying to find the right time. I'm sorry.
Keep your promise, okay?
Of course, I won't let you down. Oh, by the way, about Charles. He was able to find a gun in Rosa's bedroom.
Oh? You think she killed Victor?
I still don't know, but we were thinking that. But then if we base it on Victor's revelations from a cellular phone, then it's likely that Victor isn't the only one who was killed by that gun.
Have you told the police about this?
Not yet, but Charles and I are gathering more evidence, and we came up with a plan, and for Cassandra, Mayor Violetta, and Rosa.
What's this meeting all about?
I was able to talk to Victor's father, and you are Victor's friend, right?
Right.
He asked me to give you this.
What's this?
That's the bullet that killed Victor.
But I thought there was no bullet in Victor's body.
His father had to keep the story about the bullet a secret because it was crucial to his survival. That was embedded in Victor's spinal column. Now it's with you, so you can use it to conduct an investigation. If you're really Victor's friend, then you will do everything to find out who killed Victor and who wanted to stop him from testifying for Manning Ning.
I'm quite impressed by your former lawyer. He was dedicated, and I am actually convinced that he really is an excellent lawyer.
Mother, how about you? Are you still mad at Victor?
After what just happened to him? Of course not. And I hope someday we can bring him justice. Manning Ning, I want us to celebrate after this.
But, Congresswoman, didn't you tell me that we shouldn't celebrate until the case has finally been decided?
That's not what I meant. I want us all to celebrate when you finally get out of here. Your family and mine. You know, I really think that it won't be long before you are set free. Don't you think so, Virgie?
The Congresswoman sure has a point. Because of the information that Victor left us, I can just feel it now. It won't be long before you're free at last.
If this bullet matches the one that killed Victor, I just hope. I'm hoping my suspicions aren't true.
you're here.
Well, it's a good thing you came.
I'm glad we're still friends all along. You are here to support me there today, right?
We are not friends, Rosa. Please remember that. It just so happened that we all wanted the same thing to happen. We're here so we could warn you.
Why? Is there a danger in the courtroom?
Yes, there is, and that's you. You're a danger to us. You better be careful of the things you're going to say in that witness stand, because the minute you betray me and Cassandra, I assure you, you're going to get more than a jail sentence. I will go after your sons.
Is that Habagat?
Yes.
Go over there. Come on, what kind of friend are you? Be there for him.
Why me? I'm not good at things like that. I can't handle mushy things like that.
Well, I have no idea what to say either. I have no idea what to say to people. And you should talk to him, Armand.
No, are you crazy? Not that. They're fighting.
Well, who's going to go there?
Leave Habagat alone. He needs some time to think.
Your Honor, we are withdrawing Mrs. Perret from the list of our witnesses, and we request permission to present the video testimony of Attorney Victor Abad instead.
Is this newfound evidence, Attorney La Fortesa? Does the prosecution have any question when it comes to this change?
Your Honor, the alleged new evidence is not new. And we discussed this during the pretrial, so we have no problem, Your Honor.
Okay, then. The defense may proceed with the presentation of evidence.
Yes, Your Honor.
Maningning, if you're watching this video inside the courtroom, then that means the letter that I sent you wasn't enough to prove your innocence. And didn't I tell you that I hate to lose a case? Prepare yourself for all the things I'm about to reveal. Let me start off with the most important fact. The person who killed your sister is none other than Mrs. Rosa Perret.
Hello, can I speak to Mr. Jerry Reyes? Charles Perret. Mr. Reyes? Yes, I'm calling about my wife and attorney Victor Abad.
It's how could you? You killed my
order.
Sister!
It's order!
How dare you do it!
Order in the court! I said order in the court!
You animal! Oh, hope it's a lie!
I said order in the court!
Come on.
Order!
We better go, Rosa.
You animal! You're an
order.
Animal!
I said order in the court!
What a horrible woman. An animal. Why did she do that to Mayumi? What could your sister have done to her? How could she have killed my daughter?
Mother, those things aren't important to me anymore. Because for me, she will never have enough reason to kill Mayumi.
I swear I can kill her right now.
Mother.
I finally thought I could forget the pain. But it still hurts. I really want to kill her.
No, we're not like her, Mother.
But you have no idea. You have no idea what she did. How she caused me so much pain from the very beginning. I treated her like a good friend. One of my closest friends. I even went against your father and I helped her have a better life. Even if it meant that we had to suffer for it. And this is how the monster pays me back. How could she do that? How could she? Who does she think she really is? She didn't have the right. She had no right to go and end your sister's life.
Calm down, Mother.
She deserves to die. How could she kill Mayumi?
You are not the one who killed Daphne.
I hope you're ready, Maningning. The time has come for you to pay for all the times you came to destroy my life.
You are not the one who killed your son's wife.
Baby, I'm pregnant, please. Please.